family members on the phone. Sometimes you can't get your BFF on the phone. But this is the season where God said, I want to be your BFF. This is the season where God said, I want to be your best friend forever. Because I'm the one that's going to provide all of your needs. I'm the one that's going to begin to fulfill miraculously what you have asked. And as you become and posture yourself like Hannah, as you get to the place of prayer, God is going to begin to download on you. And as people begin to watch her, they thought that she was drunk. They thought that she was wine drinking. They thought she was one that was in there, lost her mind. Because in that season, they had a reputation of women coming there and they were drinking. But as they in that place of prayer, that's where you're going to be downloaded by the Holy Spirit. You're going to not be drunk by natural wine, but you're going to be drunk in the Spirit. You're going to pray in the Holy Ghost like never before for hours. And you're going to be endued with power. God is going to begin to download his mind upon you as you seek him. And as Hannah was in the place of prayer and at the place of Shiloh, the Bible says that as Eli perceived, his false perception of her was that she was a drunk. But the Bible says that she prayed and poured out her heart to God. And she was praying that there will be a son. And in that region and in that season of that time where they were living in, the Bible says that there was a lot of apostasy and there was a lot of corruption that was going on. And there was a lot of judges at that time. There were no kings at that time. And so in her heart, God, she did not know that she was going to birth the purposes and plan of God. She did not know that her prayer was that I want to birth a son. So the Bible said that she made a vow to the Lord. There's some vows that some of you have made to the Lord. And God said, I'm going to come after my vow. I'm going to begin to cause you to begin to renew those vows that you had before God. There's some of you said, God, if you do this and I would do that. And God said, I'm going to begin to cause you to begin to revisit those vows. I'm going to cause you to go back and revisit those promises that you had before me in private. And the Lord said, I'm going to begin to cause you to be, I'm going to remind you of those things of the past. I'm going to remind you of the prophecy that I've spoken over your life. I'm going to remind you of the things that you have dreamed about. I'm going to remind you of the things that you have written about. I'm going to remind you of the things that you have sung about. I'm going to remind you of the things that you have saw before in the past. And the Lord said, I'm going to birth it out. Turn to your neighbor and say, I'm going to birth it out. This is the season where God has said, I'm going to complete the thing that I've started. And as Hannah was in the place of prayer, she asked God for a son. And she made a vow to God. This vow was a Nazarite type of vow, because Nazarite had two terms of their vow. There was a temporary vow and then there was a long-term vow. And she said, God, if you give me a son, I will dedicate him back to you. There are some things and there are some promises and there is some prophecy that you have over your life and it seemed like it has not been fulfilled. Some things that you may not receive a prophecy at all in your life. You may not be familiar with the prophetic, but God is saying that what your mind is, I've given you a mind to think. I've given you creativity to think. I've given you a prophetic vision. I've given you prophetic insight to know some things that I have for your future. And the Bible says that as Hannah began to pray and she asked God for a son, the Bible says that Elkanah, and when she went back, Elkanah and her began to have sex. And as they began to have sex, God increased the passion. And as they began to have sex in that year, 9 months later, she began to conceive a child. That word of the Lord has came to pass. And she gave birth to a Samuel. And the Bible says that Samuel's name means acts of God. I come to announce to you that there's some things that's on the inside of you that you won't make birth. But God said, I'm going to birth a Samuel out of your life. I'm going to get something out of your life. And it's called, I'm the acts of God. There's some things that you've been asking God for. And the Lord said, I'm going to birth a Samuel. You must understand that whenever God births something in your life, you got to birth it out in prayer. There's some people that are doing some things all by themselves. They're doing it by the arms of flesh. But God said, if you begin to go in prayer, and as you begin to go in intercession, and as you begin to seek my face, I'm going to begin to reveal to you, and I'm going to show you that on the inside of you, it's a Samuel that's ready to be born. Before God can birth a Samuel out of you, as God begin to birth what you have asked, there has to be a burden. Say a burden.
A burden.
The burden that the burden that Hannah had was that it was Peninnah that provoked her into intercession. Sometimes when the warfare increases over your life, and sometimes when it gets so hard for you, it is God and not the devil that's calling you to go into the place of intercession. It's not the devil that's calling you to go to the place of prayer. It's not the devil that called you to go to the place of Shiloh. But it's God that's on the inside of you that's creating a situation so that you can seek him. Not seek your pastor, not seek a leader, not seek Obama, but God said to seek him. Shiloh. And as she was going to take him up to Shiloh, she said, no, I'm not going to take him up yet because I need to weed him. You must understand that whatever God begins to birth on the inside of you, it has to be weaned. It's just like a mother that has her child and she's weaning and she's milking their child. But there's a season of maturity. There's a season where that prophetic vision, that prophetic promise, that word that God has spoken over your life, that dream, that vision, whatever that's in your heart that you desire to do, that idea, that thing that you cannot shake. You said, I got to do this and I want to do that. And but God has said, I'm going to take that wanted. What you going to do? And I'm going to take it out of the spirit of your mind. I'm going to bring it into reality. I'm going to bring it from here and I'm going to bring it into the manifestation. And some of you are struggling with some things because you said, I don't know how to take it from here. I got to get it to here. And the Lord said, I'm going to help you as you go into intercession. As you go into prayer, God said, take your pen and your book and go in there and begin to write. And I'm going to give you the strategy. I'm going to give you the wisdom. I'm going to give you the know-how to get this thing to the earth realm. God has to give you the plan and he has to give you the purpose because God wants to begin to show you his mind towards you. When God began to birth Samuel into the earth, God knew that in this season there was going to be trade transition. God knew in this season that there was going to be a lot of corruption that was going to take place. And Eli's sons were ones that they were sitting at the gate in the priesthood. They were ones that compromised. They did not obey God. They disrespected the house of God. There's many people that come into the house of God and they carry the spirit of the sons of Eli. They come in there and they do everything in the house of God. They don't have no reverence for the house of God. Yeah. They're cursed in church. They have sex in church. And that's what Eli's sons were doing. They were having sex in church. They were cursing. They were doing everything that was not right. But this is the season where God said, I'm going to begin to deal with my church and I'm going to begin to cause my church to go through a purification process. This is the season where God is cleaning out the church. Now, I'm not talking about a building. I'm talking about this body. The body of God, the body of Christ. We are the temple of the Lord and the Holy Spirit has come to make a decision. This is the time to make a decision on your life. This is the time and season where you got to make some hard decisions. But these decisions are going to begin to cause you to move into destiny. As you begin to purify your heart and ask God, what is on your mind towards me? What is your eternal purpose and plan for me? And as you begin to seek God, God going to call you to birth it out. And as Eli's sons were doing all types of things, God knew in the season of time that there was going to be a prophet that he was going to raise up. There is a prophetic people that God is going to raise up in this hour. You may not be called to be a prophet, but God said, I'm going to give you a prophetic spirit. On the inside of you is a prophetic spirit. On the inside of you is an apostolic spirit. On the inside of you is an evangelistic spirit. On the inside of you is a leadership spirit. On the inside of you is a teaching spirit. You got to understand, you don't have to be an apostle or prophet or go and have a title, but on the inside is the Holy Spirit. I need the Holy Spirit on the inside of me to empower me and to anoint me to do what I've been called to do. And you've been called to the marketplace. God said, I'm going to give you the anointing to begin to take the ownership. I'm going to give you the anointing to begin to take territories. I'm going to give you the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And as you go in there, you're going to have strategies. You're going to have insight. You're going to have wisdom. You're going to know how to govern with authority. You're going to know how to govern with power. You're going to begin to delegate that power and that authority. And God said, this is the season where God said, I am going to come and visit you.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
And as God began to birth out Samuel, God knew that he was raising up a prophet. And as I want to jump over, and as God began to raise this prophet up, he grew in the Lord. This is the time and season where God said, you must grow in me. This is the season of maturation. This is the season where God wants to mature you. This is the season where as God begins to give you a vision, he's going to wean you off of some things. God is weaning you off of some things by his spirit. He's going to some things that you're doing, God said, you're not going to be doing tomorrow. There's some things that you're doing now that you're not going to be doing 5 years from later. You're going to understand that God is going to wean you off some things because that is transformation. That is change. That is transition. Some of us are